I know it's an ignorant look.
I just watched you rub your nip on screen. Let's see. This is what the people like. That's entertainment, baby.
You should have seen it on the movie show. All three of them got a view of JT's camel toe, too, as well.
Yeah, we saw way too much. JT stood up in his fucking track pants, and there was aggressive moose knuckle. It was not, and I called him out right away. I did. Your nips so low. They're saggy from when he had boobs.
They're not low. It's just because I'm putting my back straight.
Maybe his torso's long. Better than Seven Samurai. Oh, man.
Oh. He just runs over his belly.
You're killing me, dude. In the market for a Hollywood speak. JT, do you want to be in a movie?
What?
Do you want to be in a fucking short film?
Of course.
I think you should talk to our friend Miles.
Hey, Miles, man.
I'm sure that you would fit in. Have me on as Bigfoot as a guest, please. Just cryptid stuff. Oh, Hollywood, great. Yeah, I got it. Can you play a perverted doctor? There you go. I think it's perfect.
Who?
Me? You play a perverted doctor in a movie.
Oh, I could play a perverted doctor in real life. I see a movie, for fuck's sake.
Oh, God.
And it should say it should already. You shouldn't even have to ask. Use the second word. It could be perverted anything.
Yeah, it's true.
Right?
He's just perverted day to day. It's just about playing a doctor. Ask me to turn my head and cough. Oh, God. Why didn't I think of this before? Give me JT's agent. We'll talk.
It's right here. I represent myself.
That's funny.
No.
I don't know why. Why didn't I think of that before? That's genius.
Yeah. You know, like it's I have the voice of an angel.
Having JT in shorts is extra.
Oh yeah. You want me to pull him all the way up like an Urkel?
Like, no, you gotta like the girl at the bar.
Camel toe, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. I'd be so starstruck to be honest. I think we have to have like a fan meetup.
Why? What's so good? What's so important about me? I just come on here and I make a fool of myself.
It's great, man. Put it out, I guess. Everyone does just want to jerk off in his movie. It's true.
On his movies? Oh, that's the one we're talking about? No.
It's not a porn. He put out an ad on Craigslist. He just wants somebody to play a doctor. And everybody is just like, do I need to play it nude? Do you need me to jerk off? That's what they're all talking about in the responses. One time JT attended.
Question? Like,
Rob's Super Bowl.
Jerk off? What the fuck? That's a cool thing.
And greeted a bunch of his fans who never met him in real life. And they were frenzied. He gave them the wave and one person fainted.
I wonder if one day he's going to. This out of the 500 people or 400 and whatever people, if one day somebody's gonna notice that they've seen this somewhere and like, hey, I've seen you somewhere before.
Mm-hmm.
That never happens. I've been trying for fucking years now.
How many? Oh, I still have Pesto the Penguin open in that other tab. How many we have? What? Oh shit,
that was another fans?
No, I have subscribers. No.
426 or 8 or something like that. I don't know.
Something.
I'm not counting.
You're not counting?
No.
Let's see. 432.
Oh, fuck, man. Straight up.
We've gone up.
Saw that comic shop talk.
Mm-hmm. Your first stop for pop culture talk.
And comics.
pop culture. I mean, comics are part of pop culture, I think.
I know, Julie. I'm just messing around. But
I think
we're royal wave of one person yet, but I can do that, Nico. You want me to go? I should be on the fucking Santa Claus parade float.
That is true. I would love that. There were lots of fans, and he stood in the doorway and gave his royal wave to everyone.
That's right.
That's very... That's really funny.
People are just making my head swell. That's all. It's big enough, man, guys. I already have issues with my head.
It's like, really funny, though.
No. It's not that funny.
It is. The people love JT.
I want to be in a short, wearing shorts.
He wants to be in the short shorts, guys. This is a video clip of us reenacting it. There's a video clip?
What did I do?
Your royal wave.
Oh, I have. Yeah, I have it. Don't I have it somewhere? There is me doing it, unless he just clipped it right now.
Maybe. Are you wearing a red long sleeve shirt today? I keep noticing. Oh, no, it's just your bracelet. Oh, okay. Yeah, got it.
No. It's really on a late night. Look at that.
Turbo. Oh, God.
Is that even the next short?
I guess so. It's on our late night clips playlist.
I guess we have one. I didn't know. I know we have one doing a creepy dance on here, but I didn't know we had one of...
Oh, that's true. We do have your dance. Where is that? It's in here somewhere. Is it creepy? Where is that? It's somewhere.
It's on the banner thing.
It's right there. It's right there. See? I forgot about that. JT the creep.
In the big town of where the fuck were we at that time, Nico? I think we're in like fucking where the fuck were we?
Levi, yeah, he just came back from an expedition.
Another one?
Yep.
1.5 or 750?
Your adoring fans want to know where you've been. Subway and hummus. He went and got hummus and Subway. Is he a bike messenger? He takes the backpack on every expedition.
Maybe.
Maybe.
You know what? I used to carry my backpack with me all the time. You know that. I just carry a blue fucking
reusable bag. Run? Maybe. I don't know. Could be. Oh, sick. You know what it was? He's got a bag, all right. I was talking about making hummus the other day, and we don't have any tahini, so I couldn't make it. So he's probably been thinking about it for 2 days, and he went and bought hummus instead. Huh?
What is tahini, a spice?
It's sesame paste that you need to make it. I mean, there's probably other ways to make it, but...
I didn't know. I didn't even know that was a word. I mean...
It's like I don't know. It looks like peanut butter, but it's sesame seed based.
To make it give it that hummus color?
Oh, well, chickpeas are already the hummus color.
Is that all it is? Chickpeas?
Chickpeas and tahini and olive oil and spices.
Oh, okay. Because I like chickpeas. I just...
Make your own hummus? Sick. I try. Yeah. But I need tahini. And I don't... Or tahina? Tahini? Tahina? I forget what it's called.
Tahini?
He's got my bag from 23andMe, but I'm okay with it. Man.
You guys are too much in there. I don't know what.
I think I would do it. I'm kind of curious to see what's in my lineage. Because I don't know what's on my mom's side. I know that it's, you know, we're white, obviously, but like. probably British and Irish and obviously Scottish somewhere, but
my old man did some digging though afterwards once he found out regions and areas and looking around for the last names and my grandmother's last name before she was married. Oh my god, the stuff that I fucking thought was a little bit too much for my liking, but it kind of explains why my family's so fucked up. You know, no point intended.
Yeah.
Or whatever. But yeah. Right?
Oh my god, I'm dying.
No. Why? Is that the little one?
Yeah.
Is that just a crazy one at nighttime?
Yeah.
I didn't even know there was anything in there. That was just the way it looked.
The little one.
Oh, no. Too small, man. Too crazy.
The baby.
At that age. At nighttime, does she keep you up or what?
Oh, fuck yeah. She's crazy at night.
Right now, she won't do nothing, right? Because it's fucking... The lights just... Well, once the lights go off, she's nuts, no?
Yeah, once everybody disappears and goes to bed, she's like, all right, time to run at full speed.
No.
But she's sleepy right now. Not as cute as Poontang. Yeah, you're right. You're right. That house hippo's pretty cute.
They used to come down all the time after, like, when it was... No, sorry, that when it was young, it was always around them, whatever. Now, you don't even see the fucking cat anymore.
Yeah.
Excuse me. You don't even see the cat anymore. It's like, what happened to your little baby? I can't believe that my dad got a cat.
It's getting soft, man.
Oh, fuck. Don't you hate that? When men lose their testosterone?
Cats get zoomies in the middle of the night. I know. It's like 2 a.m., 3 a.m.
It's like me.
Full sprint, length of the apartment. Full sprint. I don't know what they're doing, but I support them.
I don't know what they're doing, but you support them? You're fine. Yeah.
Because it's funny, dude. It's funny as long as you're not in the way.
They're just fucking, yeah, they're just messing, you know, messing around, stirring shit up. That's all.
Yeah.
But could you imagine going out to take a piss in the middle of the night and all of a sudden the cat zooms in front of you and ba-boom, falls first.
She gets all, she'll like work outside the bed. She's like, because she's hard to see too, right?
That's what I mean. She's black, right? And white.
Yeah.
I mean, the other one's a little bit, you know, camouflaged. No, I see it, but I don't see her going nowhere. You get Levi to do that,
right? Huh?
Can you get Levi to do that too?
I get Levi to do that too. Holy shit, he killed that sub. Damn.
Somebody was hungry. No? No, fucking. Oh, man. But yeah, Rob went down that fucking Puff Daddy hole, he said yesterday night. He started talking to me about so much of shit. And I don't even know half of it, if it's true or not, but...
Did you see that Usher deleted his entire Twitter?
Well, because there's probably a lot of shit on there.
They didn't like, even... I mean, I guess he's trying to get rid of stuff for people to pick apart, but it's like, man, if that doesn't make you look guilty...
I mean, there's. I think there's a lot, too, that people are trying to make disappear right now. Mm-hmm. Right? And apparently they got him on, like... suicide watch.
Yeah, because they won't let him out on bail.
They're gonna put a pull a Jeffrey Epstein or whatever. Because they're gonna somebody's and hang him.
Maybe.
I watch too many TV shows that end like that, you know?
Because
of fucking money. Right?
What's this thing about Justin Trudeau you were gonna tell me about?
Oh, he was on the Stephen Colbert show. It was like fucking 14 or 15 minutes. I was wondering what he was doing in the US.
Yeah.
US television show, and I was wondering if anybody fucking had seen that, but I wasn't 100% sure. I don't know if it
I didn't see it
look worse, right?
Yeah,
I think it was more of a gameplay in a sense of what's going on down there as into their politics right now too, right?
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I'm not 100% sure, man. Apparently it was they tried to stay away from what I heard on the news today. They tried to stay away from political stuff, but there's always something that's right? Like they'll ask him, what's his, you know, what his part in the UN or his part in all that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's just, it's weird because I know there's a bunch of shit going on over here and talking about early elections and shit like that, right? So I was wondering if that's why he did it, tried to pull a power move like that, or.
I don't know. I didn't. I'll probably see it tonight when I'm on TikTok and stuff. There'll be clips.
I know. I'm pretty sure the U.S. doesn't know much about Canada, period.
Yeah, I don't know.
Much about it. It's not like it's everybody follows them, apparently, right? So that's the problem.
At least that's what they think, I guess.
I don't know, man. You don't see, and like I said, unless you're reading articles, who the fuck wants to read? When there's stuff on, you know.
I mean, I do, but okay.
Yeah. I'd rather listen to talk like a talk radio or something where they start to discuss it like that as opposed to podcasts. I like actual, you know, that's the funny thing, but you got to pick and choose your stations. AM stations are weird like that. Some are left wing, right wing, some are a mixture.
Yeah.
Be really careful on, well, not really careful, but you got to know what you want to listen to, right?
Yeah.
If you want a good debate, you go to one station. If you want to listen to a one-sided, you know, and you go station. I'm pretty open-minded with anything. It really doesn't matter at the end of the fucking day to me. Exactly. Right? And that's a person like that can be walking around your streets any day at any time.
Wild. Are you wearing the same clothes in that?
Same sweater.
Nice. What are those shoes you're wearing? I don't think I've ever seen you wear those before. You were dressed up that day.
Oh, those are one time. Yeah, those are one time. I think I still got them in the closet over here.
One time only?
Those are one time only. That was a specialty.
Mm.
No, but yeah, no, I can't. You made me lose my train of thought when you put a creeper like JT walking the streets. Oh, they wanted to fucking. I've been trying to fight this fucking fucking speeding ticket.
Another one?
No, it's from like 2 years ago.
Oh, the same one. Okay, fine. Yeah, what happened?
I got it.
Wait, are you allowed to talk about it?
I don't care, man. Who's watching this? The three of you.
Well, the three of us. I think there's four of us.
But yeah, so at the end of the day, it was a speeding ticket I was bringing. That was the day I think we were with Chris from Comic Shop Talk there. Where the fuck I was? I'm home from somewhere. I think we were either, I don't know, we went axe throwing or we went to a fucking, it was something like that. We were all together. I was with Nico and him, and I'm pretty sure you were there.
That was the axe throwing thing, I think.
Yeah.
This guy's because snacking big time.
He's got the munch.
He's got snacks.
He can put a face to that. Well, very in the distance. If you can zoom in on your fucking cameras, guys, no. But not me. Where'd you go?
I was trying to put me on the fucking. I don't know how to do it. Oh, never mind. Whatever.
You can do this.
I don't know how to do it.
No, I don't know how to do it either.
Both of us not knowing how to do it. Okay, whatever. Anyway.
So.
Moving on.
No. Yeah, so we try to fucking fight this fucking speed camera. Yeah. It was a speed camera, too. It wasn't even like a real police officer.
Yeah.
It was just a camera that was on one of the places. So I was driving home when I got it because I literally was doing maybe, I think I have it, the ticket actually says 5 over. So I missed the court date. That was during the time I was in the hospital.
Ticket for 5 over.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
That's what I'm getting pissed off about, right? Is this is where I'm going with this because anything up to 5 over, you can get a ticket for. I mean, if it was a regular cop, you might have got away with it, but you know probably how hard it is? You know how hard it is in any regular car nowadays to drive even over this anything under the speed limit? Not like you literally you might as well just ride the brake because I think your cruising speed is your rolling speed is faster than the fucking speed in the city, right?
Right.
But now they're talking about putting more of these speed trap cameras everywhere.
Yeah.
Top of it, downtown, which, you know, how much I fucking love driving down that place. I had some fucking crazy bitch the other day that was pouring right at my window because she was trying to make a left. And, yeah, I said bitch, guys, because, you know what?
That's could have been worse.
Yeah. Or, you know, but at the end of the day, she tried to cut in and make a left at a spot. You know, you're waiting on Young to get to the fucking highway. It takes you 30 minutes just to move, you know, half a block.
Yeah.
Down there, right? Like, I was literally underneath the GO train fucking tracks there for 20 minutes in that tunnel, just sitting in that tunnel. Literally.
Yeah.
You know, so those fucking cameras, they want to put those cameras now in like middle of an intersection. So if you get stuck in the middle of an intersection, you're not blocking it for everybody that's walking. Right? When did walking become so important? Hey, when did it trump fucking cars? Really, at the end of the day.
Jesus.
No, okay, this is the part that pissed me off. And if she was looking from where she was looking, there's no left. You have to go around the fucking island and try to get in there. And she thought I was going to let her in. And then she honks the horn right at my ear. Right?
Yeah.
Literally, because her fucking SUV, the hood of it is right there at my fucking ear with my window wide open.
Right.
Right. But she's blocking off the northbound traffic. This is what fucking pisses me off. People like that. You're making it. You're honking at me because people are honking at you. Go fuck yourself because you didn't want to do something the right way.
Right.
I'm not, you know. Plus, it didn't help that I was waiting already for fucking 20 minutes underneath that fucking tunnel.
Yeah.
You know, but at the end of the day, it was like, really? Like my cigarette. Right? It was done anyway, so I flicked it out the window.
Yeah.
Right?
And
it was on her. It was apparently it landed on her windshield, right? So she's trying to follow me now. Right now, I know I had pissed her off.
You know,
I pissed her materials, and then that was it, man. Right? God forbid you try to tell somebody how to drive in the city, right?
Yeah.
Or get pissed off about it. I mean, yeah. I could have been like my uncle or the guy that met my uncle and threw a fucking bottle of water through her window, right? But I didn't. I flicked my cigarette on the windshield. She's protected. It's not going in the car. But it stays on the windshield wiper thing, right? And it was still lit. So I could see how that might have pissed her off. So she's trying to chase me down. And there's no traffic. So we get to a part at the bus stop. She puts her car in park, and I'm waiting, and I watch her from like a car and a half away throw it back towards my car. Obviously, it didn't land on my car, but she tried to do that. She didn't approach the car.
Yeah.
Right. But fuck, man. You got to love the city. You got to love it, man. You know, if the one thing I've learned about taking it easy with the marijuana is that sometimes the patience isn't there.
Yeah.
Right? You know, that patience that JT's so fondly known for?
Yes.
Yes. That patience doesn't...
Life moves a little bit slower for JT.
But that's not like that. It hasn't been like that. And it's been fucking driving me nuts because I'm trying to figure out how to control that. It's like when it's like I watch an Avengers. It's like the Hulk, man. If he pisses me off, I'm going to turn green.
Wait, okay, hold on. So you missed your court date for the speeding ticket.
Yeah. So I'm trying to fight that one. I'm trying to fucking reopen it. But that's what I'm trying to say. They're putting more of these fucking cameras everywhere. You know, so you got to really watch out.
Yeah. Right. PSA to the people.
Yeah, right? If fucking... But yeah, speaking of grass, the other day I tried some of this fucking... I don't know what it was.
Yeah.
I was laughing like a fucking hyena.
Nice.
No, I...
No?
I mean, yeah, it was nice. I mean, it was nice. this is something that you can't, it doesn't look like you can buy it unless it's a pre-rolled. And I fucking hate buying pre-rolls.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Because a buddy had let me try it. And I don't know what the percentage was. It must have been something crazy. It had to have been.
Mm-hmm. 30 plus.
Oh, it was for sure. I mean, I smoke over 30 plus, but I think it was a sativa, if I'm not mistaken. So it had me giggling.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not used to it. I'm used to more of a punch in the face.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Why? You think sativas aren't they the ones?
There was an audio loop for a second. That's what the face I made.
But am I right about the sativas being
the ones that make you typically, yeah. Yeah.
I mean, it is a smack in the face until you what do you call it? Until you start laughing, and then all of a sudden when the giggles come in. The problem was I had to hang around for a few hours because I was at a buddy's place.
Yeah.
And you couldn't see my eyeballs. It made my fucking laugh. It made my eyes so swollen.
Mm-hmm.
Right? From being scrunched. So you know, you're not supposed to, guys, do not ever never smoke and drive, okay? It's a bad thing. We don't condone that on the show. We don't condone that.
Not allowed.
No. So, but yeah. I'm just saying, if you ever fucking get a chance, something community by Purple Hill, I think it's called.
Okay.
Keep your, you know.
Purple Haze?
No. It's Purple Hill.
Purple Hill.
Yeah, I actually have a fucking picture of it, which is funny.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
I had to take a picture of I wanted to take a picture of the vial, right, that it came in?
Yeah.
Or it could be Hills, sorry.
Purple Hills? Community something. Huh.
Yeah, it's Purple Hills. But I don't know, man. I didn't take it. I should have took a side shot of the fucking THC content.
I'm behind on the weed brands. I don't know what's going on anymore.
I don't know, man. I don't either. I don't touch much. I usually just grab what I want to grab.
Yeah.
Because I'm not smoking as much as I was, literally. Like,
I'm just into gummy anymore.
Still having a hard time with that one's a big. That's going to be the fucking hardest one of them all, I think, to be honest with you guys.
Probably.
Trying, right? I went like this to look for my coffee. I don't have it anymore. I finished it. It was the one I had. I was nippling, huh? Nippling. I was nipping. Sorry.
You were nippling. Couldn't open his eyes. He was trying to test. Yes, please. The cat's
come on.
Fucking around beside in an Amazon box.
Nico, huh? You got a video of it?
He took a video.
I can send you a video of JT when he couldn't open his eyes and was trying to test his setup.
I guess he took a video of me. We'll send that. Send it in that. In chat. Got it.
Yeah. Nico fast. Nice. Nico fast, man. He's one of those guys downtown that when you're, he's doing this, texting with these, right? So he's texting with the fingers like this. He's fast as fuck.
Like this?
Maybe three or four fingers he uses altogether.
I text with my thumbs.
Yeah, but he does it with all of them, man. It's like every finger goes off. It's like...
hockey.
And he's able to focus straight, like, and still be able to walk forward while he's doing that.
Mm-hmm. I can walk and text, but yeah.
Oh, I'd walk into a car or into the street when it's green. I wouldn't be able to fucking focus like that.
Yeah.
I don't know how people do that, man. That's all you see. And then I'm just trying to dodge people.
My phone sends me a warning if I'm walking and texting. It says, look where you're going.
Come on.
It sends me a thing. If I'm walking and I'm texting, or if I'm watching a thing and I'm walking, it says, look, it sends me a warning at the top with a little green thing. Like a little symbol of a guy walking. And it says,
you might hurt yourself.
It says, look where you're going. I forget what it says.
What is it? It's because is it a newer phone, a newer Apple?
No, this is a Google phone, but hold on.
Better. I can't. I gotta stick.
It's called a heads up warning. It says, get reminders to stop using your phone while you're walking. Use with caution. Heads up doesn't replace paying attention.
Is it really called heads up warning?
Yeah.
I wonder if everybody has that.
And it says it has permission to detect my physical activity and detect my location and to send me notifications. But yeah, it's like.
No.
It's a little dude walking. It says heads up.
No, I don't get that. They don't like. They don't care if I walk
in. Yeah, just like how I get the fucking sound effects when we're on the phone, so I can send you farts.
Well, that's pretty crazy. I'm that probably gonna do my.
Can't even get hit by a car while texting anymore because of woke. I know exactly.
Yeah, fuck, man. Sorry, it's true though.
Yep.
Save your ass. Everything's about saving your ass. Fuck that.
Yep.
Well, if you're gonna cancel me, cancel me.
For what? You were uncanceled earlier, remember?
I was uncanceled. I don't mind, but
I don't remember why, but you were uncanceled.
I'm getting canceled at 300, guys. Don't worry.
Should we talk about 300?
I don't know. I just remembered Nico bringing it up earlier.
Is that what he was talking about?
I feel like it, but I'm not 100% sure.
Well, you may as well. You may as well talk about it.
Yeah, slowly. Guys, at 300 episodes, I think we're going to put this thing to sleep for now. You know?
Tell the people.
Maybe a reemergence one day. Maybe a reemergence one day and something else, but they're going to be a lot of fucking... a lot of changes coming in the new year. Let's just put it that way. So, you know, Nico will keep us all updated with it anyways, but... I'll tell you right now.
Oh, I knew he was gonna fucking flounder. He couldn't fucking say it. Oh right? Boy.
But yeah, no, it, I just don't know when the date's gonna be. So keep your eyes and ears to the chat.
It's the countdown to episode 300, guys.
Yeah, to episode. Yeah, but there's still gonna be all kinds of content on the fucking channel, guys, that we're gonna be putting out weekly.
Yeah. I think that's the important thing to clarify, that like the channel's not ending. We're not stopping making stuff. We're just, we're going to take a hiatus from an indefinite hiatus from the standard late night chat show, this particular show.
Because we're not late night, obviously.
Well, that's not part of it. That's got nothing to do with it. The time of day is fucking up our numbers. That's not it. It's everybody's getting busy. This guy's doing fucking 100 things. Nico's doing 100 things. Lewis is busy. Lewis has got a kid.
That's at the end of the day, too. TV show to watch. Don't worry. You can come watch me on the other shows, Nadine. Don't worry.
You know what that reminds me of? That fucking. There's a meme that spelling. Reminds me of. Oh, which God. Me? Hold on, I'll pull it up.
Oh, man. But yeah, no, it's like I said, we're going to be doing all kinds of other shows. Fuck, man.
Yeah.
Nico's already sent me a new show to watch.
This one.
Yes. I hope that's what
it's like. It's not over. We're still doing the movie show. We're still doing all kinds of stuff. We'll still do shooting the shit. I'm not done with it. Julie's I'm not. We're gonna. I know. I'm not.
We're forever.
I'm busy as fuck too, but this is entertaining as hell for me.
She likes to see me make a fool of myself. I think there's a couple of them to do.
I think we're an equal part there, buddy. We opportunities for other shows similarly, and I chat. Yeah, exactly. You know, a shooting the shit, and every now and then.
You know, fucking all kinds of random stuff. It's gonna
battle
be a lot
of the bangers, maybe. Like, you know.
You know what? It's so funny that you brought that
I
up.
I know. Yeah. Why?
It's so funny that you brought that up because Leslie had brought that up to me about how she's the only the reigning champion or whatever.
Somebody's gonna knock her down off that fucking throne.
Talking about it at her cousin's the other day, and I was like,
ooh. Man,
something like it could.
Take right? a shot at the title, buddy.
I could. I mean, because I would have, I would at least have two then, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I won one title once already. I think I might have won more than one. No, just one.
I haven't won any. I think I was only in one battle. Maybe two?
Yeah, well, you don't listen to enough music.
I listen to lots of music. I just don't listen to your shit.
Well, that's the problem. See, this is where I had an argument with Leslie, because I'm trying to keep up with all the new shit nowadays.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So, like, I'm trying to keep up with all the music that's coming out nowadays. And you know, they there's people that are very set in there, especially when it comes to hip-hop or especially when it comes to certain types of music.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Fred, it all depends on the mood that you're in. Like I've always said, I was trying to explain to you, there's a couple songs she played to me the other day, and she was playing them a lot recently. Mm-hmm. But think about it. It's got to do with what her life is going through right now. Like, well, I mean, just having a son at a certain age. So there's certain songs that you can relate to when times change in your life.
Yeah.
Right? So you got to kind of stick with that. Mm-hmm. I don't see a lot of artists like they used to maybe make music like that anymore. I can agree with beyond something like that.
Yeah.
But there's always going to be a song out there that's going to make a couple, like a chorus or a couple of lines in a music song that's going to relate to each person individually. If not, if it doesn't relate to them, then it doesn't relate to them. But like it certain times in your life, music becomes a lot more important, I've noticed. And I think that's when people start to mature when it comes to listening to music. And and especially like I try to explain to my nephew, the older one, he doesn't like to listen to certain things, right? Like, and I get it. He's 19. He's not, what kind of music is he going to listen to? Right? Finger.
He said he's like super self-aware of it now.
But yeah, so I try to tell him that he's got to try to, you know, change his listening. I mean, that's when you know you've come a long way, when you've changed from one type of music to the other type of music. I can't do that. It's making me laugh.
Yeah.
Is he whistling Three Blind Mice?
I don't know what he was whistling. What was that?
Three Blind Mice.
Oh, it's from a game he's playing, but it does sound like Three Blind Mice. You know what I was just thinking? This is kind of unrelated to your thread about music, but maybe this is the opportunity with, you know, episode 300 up and coming and clearing up some time for other projects. Maybe this is the birth of JT on the road.
Oh yeah, we keep saying that. My car's gonna be broken before then.
Damn it. I have such a fucking good vision in my head of like where to put the GoPros. We each have a fucking mic and I get to edit it and it's great. In my head, it's great. And I think we have that fucking Soprano song or whatever at the beginning, like you did in that one video. We'll get copy-striked for it every fucking time.
That was a classic though.
I know. I think it's brilliant, though.
Yeah, that Tony Soprano moment was classic. Hey, Neeks, you should put that in there, that clip for your late night at the movies. Just throw it in there right at the beginning. Have me driving like Tony Soprano.
I think it's a great idea.
Oh, that'd be fucking hilarious.
I have three. I can't remember if I have three or four GoPros. I have at least three. I know exactly what angles I want.
You can just put them in there, and I'll just record nonstop. Like, you don't even understand. I'm in my car more than I'm in the house.
I know.
You can just record random shit. I can just literally record random shit.
In the backseat, I'll drive the car. We actually did do something fun on our episode. What do you mean? Then you can focus on talking about the documentary. Yeah.
No,
I'll wear the Bigfoot suit while he drives the car.
Oh, you know, that would be fucking cool.
Yeah.
I could my chauffeur.
Yeah. The Sopranos have... one. There you go.
Yeah. No, I know I understood what you said.
I didn't get it. I didn't understand.
No, because I was trying to tell him to put some that clip up for like the reel or something, you know?
Yeah. I know exactly how to fuck. I can envision it really well in my head.
You don't even know, like, the amount. Like, if it was recording nonstop and you just had to go through and edit and pick things, the stuff that you would get would be classic, especially
like instant on the classics. It would be comedy gold. It's like, in my head, it's like comedians in cars getting coffee.
There's got to be a way to set it up, too, with the audio so that it... Fuck, I'm just trying to think about it because, honestly... The stuff that goes on in that car, I mean, yeah, is not very fun.
Debauchery.
Yeah, it's not the stuff that used to go on in my car when I was younger.
It was a different car. That's the thing. We've done a lot, and I don't foresee us not doing other things. True.
But that's the whole point, right?
The Hot One Show was a lot of fun.
I think I have pictures of that shit from when you guys... I was looking for pictures on my phone, and I didn't realize that sometimes these... Like, I didn't realize when I was going through my gallery, the pictures double up sometimes. And I'm going, how do I have copies from this?
Because sometimes it'll back up a copy from, like, when you sent it to somebody. Like, if you sent one in WhatsApp, it backs up your WhatsApp media gallery, like, your outgoing. It happens to me, too.
I get that, like, on... Yeah, WhatsApp is the worst. WhatsApp sends it all to my fucking... I gotta get rid of that because it sends everything and anything, even doesn't matter what group.
I know, I have all the fucking gifts and shit that you guys send to each other all saved in my phone.
It's like, fuck. But I mean, you know, I'm in stuff too with work and whatever, right? Like, I getting all these weird fucking pictures. You know what, bro, next time you're gonna walk home,
there's an episode right there. Because you take it, Max.
No. It'll be me driving slowly along the side of the road while Max is there, and I'm trying to say, get in the car, you little bitch.
And he's complaining about all the garbage in the fucking passenger seat. Trailer Park Boys. Get the clearance stick, Ricky.
No, but I don't put stuff on my car. Just in the car. How do you get your...
You gotta take your passenger door off.
Well, we need a broom, like from the curling club. Hey, I need to make room for fucking people to sit in the car. Okay, hold on a sec, guys. Open the other door. Just push it all out like I'm sweeping. Sweep, sweep.
Did you clean it? You clean it when you give Julie a ride. No.
I don't clean it for a girl. You think I'm going to clean it for you? So, not you, Julie, but
I'm used to white trash. That's hilarious. Aw.
Grease ball.
He just moves whatever's on the seat and throws it in the back. And I just put my feet into whatever the fuck is on the floor of the passenger side.
When I drive like Nico and Christine home, what I do is the seat behind the passenger seat, everything I take from there, the back passenger seat, I just move it from that side behind my seat now. Now there's an extra spot. There you go. Done and done.
This will inspire you to clean the car for the show.
Oh, it won't.
You don't want people to see that piece of shit like that.
No, but I don't really care. Come on. You think I care? Look at my fucking room, man.
Oh, my God.
Come on, guys. This is a single life. It's the best life, man. You don't have to fucking prove anything to anybody. You don't have to fucking... Oh. It's okay, bro. I shit my pants while I sat in there one time. It's all good, buddy. And I'm not lying. I went over a bump. You know, remember Parenthood with Steve Martin? Anybody out there remember that one? When you're sliding into home and your pants are...
I forgot that you fucking shit yourself in the car.
Yeah, it was fun. too. That was great. See? This is the end of GT. This is called JT. Oh,
my God.
I'm trying to take lessons.
JT's car keys.
Well, bro, it wasn't me, man.
Oh, fuck. Maybe that is car. Funny.
I don't know what you're doing with my car, man. That's kind of crazy, Miles. And they wonder why I have spiders in my car.
Car spiders. Great episode.
I have to clean. I have to kill a spider at least once a night.
Oh, no Jesus.
There's no word of a lie about that. Yeah, bro. I didn't shit my pants while you were in the car. Trust me, you would have known that, bro. I would have made a point to let you know that one.
Oh, my God. Bothered. Oh, my God. Jeez, this is so funny. Oh.
Yeah, no, it was a fun ride.
I'm fucking crying.
Yeah, exactly. Tell him, Nico. They're from the outside of the car. I don't know where they're coming from. But obviously from the fucking trees that I live around, man. But you know what? Actually, it did. If you really want to think about it, I think I got it the first time in like the last end of December and beginning of January. So I think I might have started that whole thing.
I'm still laughing about the burger eating the other burger. That's really funny. Oh, fuck. I swear. Five bags, yeah. This is going to be ground zero. Oh, my Lord.
Bags of hockey cards. Yeah, what about the fucking 10... It wasn't a bad car when
I had. What's in the trunk of your car, dude? If all of that shit's in the seats, what's in the trunk?
I can't tell you that because if I tell you that, then it makes you an accomplice. And
where are the bodies, Garth?
Right.
Oh my God.
If I tell you that,
fucking happy and pangolin. this is my favorite bit. This is good.
It's not that bad. Like, really. I mean, it's a mess, don't get me wrong, but nobody's in it ever. I think the only person that's ever in it is maybe Nico.
I can't wait for us to make the show. I can't wait for us to make the JT on the road.
Oh, you're gonna love it. Yeah. When I can lay back, relax. Didn't you see me on the movie cast? I was sitting in a fucking lawn chair.
Yeah.
A camping chair, whatever the hell you call it.
Shield. Camping so chair? Chill,
like this?
Oh, yeah.
Oh. That's how I got Rob set up now, too. When he's fucking recording at home now, he's set up on his thing where he can lay back and pull his fucking thing back. It looks all nice.
Oh man.
No, he's just full of shit. I'm pretty sure he's full of shit that day. Sounds too much. Did you find out about Greg wants to take you to?
Oh man.
Oh, so
I cannot wait. I want to make that show so bad.
My carton of milk.
Until he fell asleep for what?
When he's on the when he's sitting comfortable in that chair that I got him with recording.
Oh man. Okay, no, I have it's
he's the, trying only, to leave.
The only thing that's yeah, it's a missing car. The only thing that's
funny, I said the other day I said that to Leslie. I said if she was my real sister, I'd put myself on a milk carton.
Oh my God. The only thing that I know would be difficult about it is that all of these JT on the road episodes would take place at night and there's no light in your car. And driving around with the lights on inside your car is a fucking unhinged thing to do. So we would just have to be in the dark. But there's part of that that's really funny to me.
Yeah, think about it. It's like a voiceover. Kinda. It's just like my voice.
One time, I was in JT's car.
Wait. Hold on. Give me a second to read that one. One time I was in the car and I actually in the car, the seat was missing and there was a huge hole and I was sitting inside an actual body of a car. What the fuck are you talking about?
That's why I drew the Bigfoot suit. But we can set up the chairs in the back of a cube van. That's funny as fuck.
I can't remember. I'm trying to think of what Nico the fuck's
talking about. I don't know what the fuck he's talking about either.
It's missing. And there's a huge hole. And I'm sitting inside the actual body of the car.
Maybe there was no seat?
When I had no license and I didn't have... The car was just like a carry-around. Like, that's when I didn't have a license and I was parked. That's what I'm starting to think. There was a time when the chair was missing and then we had to sell it. I mean, I had to get rid of the car, right?
Ended up my fucking face hurts. That's so funny.
Folding chairs. You're lucky, man. I remember that when you asked next time you're in my car.
Oh my god.
You guys love it.
It's a good idea.
Well, I mean, we've been talking about it for years. But we just talked about that. You could probably get DNA from my car. I can tell you how. There's a few cars that I've left my DNA in.
Nah, his car's got eco mode, bro. Oh, boy.
Can't mess our complete shitbox. Come on. Come on, man. You got to think of it better like that. No, I had a car one time where I had a, what do you call it, a milk crate?
Mm-hmm. Instead of a seat? Oh.
Up this part from the between that and the back seat, there was a milk crate. As this fucking part broke, that one was a factor.
Oh, and it was holding it from falling back.
Literally broke the fucking seat off the fucking back of the seat. I had to get my buddy to weld it.
You've had some prime shitbox cars in your day, buddy.
I've driven everything, Julie. I don't even remember the cars that I've driven. There's so many. I've driven so many cars in my life.
Yeah.
Even prior to losing my license for 10 years, right? Mm-hmm. I did a lot of different driving, and then now, right? I mean,
yeah.
Still, even when I wasn't driving, I was living in the fucking car.
Yeah.
You know, it's my comfort. It's my comfort zone.
And that's why we need to make the show.
Very limited comfort zone, guys. That's why I've always wanted to record from the floor of the washroom.
Like the chat. That would be funny too. I can envision the angle and you're just holding the microphone while you lay on the floor.
I always said, I sit cross-legged when I'm doing that. I could still do that. I could still pull that off.
Nice.
My legs fall asleep once in a while, but
so do mine.
You know. You know you're getting old when your hips hurt when you get up after fucking 4 hours of watching a football game on your phone in the washroom. Don't ask me, guys. I wasn't on the toilet for 4 hours. I'll tell you that much.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I don't know. I don't need a big place to live. All I need is somewhere I can shit, piss, and sleep. That's it, man.
You are a fucking character, man.
I try to.
This is why the people love you.
I'm just my own person, man.
You're such a character.
People wonder why I'm single still. I don't know why they can't. They get so dumbfounded that I'm.
Oh, single. There's somebody out there.
Never. Are you crazy? And if there is, I don't even know if I want to meet them. If there's somebody out there for me, if they can put up with my bullshit.
Oh man,
you can put up with some of the
stuff.
He
lived there already, for Christ's sake.
What?
Roberto.
Oh, no, yeah, but fuck. He didn't stick around long. See? Didn't take him.
It wasn't his fault.
No.
Nope.
Could have been.
All right. No. It's been 2 hours. Should we run the promos again and wrap it up?
There was promos? Oh, yeah, there was promos.
You're in charge of the fucking promos.
Guys, so thank you again for making Julie piss herself the whole time.
Oh, my God. This is the hardest I've laughed in ages.
Yeah, so, and the most confused I've been in ages. But it seemed to work out. You know, I'm not as witty as Julie. And Julie, if she laughs, then she can make me laugh. There you go.
Fucking entertainment for days.
Entertainment for days.
That's why I'm not giving up on the network.
Well, that's it. And, oh, we got plenty of your stuff for you to do, too, vaccines.
Mm-hmm. Hey, well, that was sus.
No, that wasn't. You know what I'm talking about, because people, yeah, if they're inside, they know her. She's a videographer and all that fun stuff, a photographer and a videographer and a voyeur. No.
A voyeur. More or less. Continue the late night chat. Don't you worry.
We need to
J2. Man, I haven't used that in ages.
No, I know. It's been a while, eh?
There it is. Oh, God.
Come on, Sal.
Oh, that's Jesus. So
I'm not that bad.
Mm-mm.
I make sure they're at least 20. Like, come on, man.
Anyway.
No, like, actually, you know what? I'll tell you the one thing I really did. I felt like I was an old man sitting outside of Nico's work the other day waiting for him.
Yeah.
And all the college, university girls that just finally figured out it's pub night.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I remember that. Well, at least if they're at pub night, they're drinking, so they've got to be legal, right?
Yes.
But I felt like the biggest perv, like, you know, those they could have been my kids. Like, I mean, I could have kids. God. Could you imagine when you think about it that way? Like, I was having a mind fuck. It was a complete, like, do I stare? Do I not stare? Do I just stare? Do I not stare?
The internal battle.
And then this thing too, because that'll make it even creepier. No?
Yes.
That was like my V for Vendetta chin.
Yeah, kind of. Your pointy chin.
It's not that pointy when I shave my beard. But, yeah, guys. Well, like I said, we're not going anywhere for a little while. So, guys, still make sure to tune in. Check this one out. The first half is out tomorrow. And then the second half will be out next Monday on the 30th. So don't forget about that. And, guys, also, make sure to like and subscribe. But, you know, you have this week we had, or every week, guys, check out Comic Shop Talk. They're putting out at least weekly episodes of Comic Shop Talk. So make sure to check that out. And if you didn't see on the 26th, or if you want to see on the 26th, check out Late Night Movies with me, Julie, Max, and Nico. And we just did the Rush Hour part one with Chris Tucker and Jackie Chan, right? And mm-hmm. I don't know why I had to say, but yeah. And then yeah, October 3rd, you got a new episode of Late Night at the Movies, and that's also an impromptu one where Max and Nico did a HBO two-parter documentary of Wise Guys with mm-hmm. David Chase Soprano. So make sure to check that one out, because that one's pretty crazy, and I'd like to see what they did on that on their Sopranos episode, now that he's got me wondering. So that'd be kind of cool to see. But yeah, on a brighter note, guys, make sure to like and subscribe. We're Late Night Chat, your one-stop shop. I don't even know, for pop culture talk, I guess. I don't know why I said they say it right way.
Pretty close. No, your first stop for pop culture.
Your one stop. One stop only. There's no other stops you got to go. That's what I'm trying to say.
Your one stop shop.
Your one stop shop. Because if you shop and stop anywhere else, you're in trouble. Fight Night. Did you watch it? And what did you think? Ah, and guess who's in it? Don Cheadle, buddy.
No one is shopping. Oh, man.
Sounds cute when you say it like that.
Your first stop for pop culture talk. Or not. Yeah,
you know what? I just need a banner. That's all.
Sometimes that's true.
It's going to make it a banner straight up.
I can do it.
That actually makes so much more sense, right? Like when you do it that way. So.
Yeah. My dad died. Aww. Still on my bad side. That's how I know that I'm back on my shit. Because I'm that fly. Call me the Titanic. I've been known to fuck up entire crews. Treat your click like trying on fitted hats. I'm capsizing you like a waiter do with a tray of food. Haters, you cater to them. I talk my shit, but I back it up. Take the hate and I make it fuel. Nothing else left to say or do. Got dessert, a fork, plate, and spoon. Must have put my money where my mouth is, cause I got my cake and I ate it too. Ate it too.
But they bite off of this cause they like my shit. No fucks, take offense, but you like that shit. Yeah, 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 yeah. She'll fight over dick cause she like my